Packers. Hi, everyone. Welcome to NHL Tonight. A $1.3 billion palace, Levi Stadium.
How do you like the party that you created tonight?
Oh,
it's a new day in the NHL.
We welcome in a special guest, Commissioner Gary Bettman, as we welcome you in NHL Live, powered by Constellation. 90 minutes away from game time. A huge game between two great teams fighting for their playoff lives. We love the weather. We love the crowd. We love the stadium. I think we're in love with this thing.
Live from the BB&T Center, it's the 2015 NHL Draft, the most anticipated draft in 10 years. Not one, but two generational players. We are counting you down to the first round alongside Brian Boucher, EJ Raddick, and Dave Reed. I'm Mark Rowe. We are in Sunrise, which is fitting because it's a new day in the NHL. And tonight, Dave, it begins with Connor McDavid going number one.
Well, Connor McDavid one, Jack Eichel number two. Both these players, you said it, generational players. This
NHL career starts tonight.
All right, so for the next 90 minutes, we'll have all your draft news, emphasis on news, because it's been a busy day. Let's start with the trades, and let's start with the Boston Bruins, who have traded Milan Lucic to the LA Kings for goaltender Martin Jones, their first-round pick in this draft. It's the 13th overall pick, and prospect Colin Miller. Now, earlier in the day, defenseman Dougie Hamilton went to the Calgary Flames for their first round pick. It's the 15th overall pick. Two second round picks are also going to the Boston Bruins. They have the 45th and 52nd overall pick, so we'll hear a lot from the Boston Bruins on stage. But let's start with that first deal that we talked about, Milan Lucic, Brian. Such a huge part of that Bruins team, but now he's going to the LA Kings.
Now on NHL Tonight, back to the pond. The Ducks and Hawks square off in Game 5 with both just two wins away from a spot in the Cup Final.
Shot score off the faceoff Bogdan! 3-0 Anaheim!
Big superstars, then big goalies.
Passes off Palat to Stamkos, he scores!
The Lightning are on the verge of their first Cup Final in 11 years.
There's a blast, rebound, score!
But this Rangers team is no stranger to a comeback. The question is, do they have another one left in them? The days are getting hotter. The game's even tougher.
The score! Jonathan Toews ties it with 37 seconds remaining.
We keep marching towards the greatest trophy in sports, and NHL Tonight has it covered. What more can you ask for in a series? Hi, everyone. Welcome to NHL Tonight alongside Mike Rupp and Kevin Weeks. I'm Mark Rowe. Game 5 of the Western Conference Final went down on Monday night at the Honda Center between the Ducks and the Blackhawks. It is all tied at 2. It's a best of 3. Chicago's two victories in the series have come in either double or triple overtime, while Anaheim is still without a regulation loss in the playoffs. In the first period, here come the Ducks. Jiří Sakic chases down Kyle Kaminsky. Sakic wins the battle, finds Francois Boschman, who fires it wide.
Great job dogging the puck, making things happen by pure hustle.
Then it's Nate Thompson getting to the loose puck to Cam Fowler. His shot beats Corey Crawford for a second of the postseason. The Ducks 6-0 when they score first.
Big man hockey by the Ducks. Take a look at this isolation battle along the wall with Timonen and also Cogliano. Cogliano wins the foot race, gets back to the net, draws Timonen. Ducks shoot around the screen, does Cam Fowler, and on the board, 1-0.
Just 32 seconds there, the Hawks unable to clear it. Jakob Silfverberg's shot redirected in by Ryan Kessler, his sixth. The Ducks score 2 on their first 3 shots.
Great play by Kessler, getting in there, getting the hit, and knowing what he needs to do is get in front of that net. Beautiful tip.
More from Sakic, who gets sent on a partial breakaway, looking to make it 3-0. But his shot goes off and he runs over Crawford.
Jiří Sakic goes with the backhand. I thought he was going to cut back to the middle of the ice, but nonetheless, Crawford wanted a call there. Great job by the officials explaining.
Ducks 0-for-6 on the power play at home in this series. Fowler across to Sammy Vatanen, and Crawford slides to make the big save.
A little bit of a hope play here, but it works out to be all right. A little tic-tac. Not quite the toe. Good save there by Crawford.
All right, so the Ducks looking to keep it coming and to make it 3-0. 5 minutes left in the period. It's Getzlaf who wins the draw. Sammy Vatanen's blast, his third, beats Crawford. 3-0 Ducks.
The Ducks own the faceoff circle, and no better example of how and why that's so critical. The captain, Getzlaf, back to Vatanen. and he blows it by Crawford on the blocker side.
Getzlaf ties his own franchise record with 18 playoff points. Now, over 16 minutes into the game, Jonathan Toews fires Chicago's first shot on net. They were outshot 11-3 through one period. Now, the Blackhawks have won 4 of 6 games in the postseason after allowing 3 goals in a period. Teuvo Teravainen comes flying up the ice in the second. He cuts to the middle and beats Frederik Andersen for a second of the playoffs.
This is a tough one. He's going to want this one back in Andersen, but great job by Teravainen getting in the middle of the ice and throwing the puck on net.
Now, a little bit later, Patrick Kane finds Toews cutting through the middle. Toews gets around Boschman, but Andersen makes the save.
That's a power move by the captain. Outside, inside, great stop, though, by Andersen. Toews frustrated with himself, said, I gotta bury that one, but power move.
Here come the Ducks. Fowler ahead to Sakic. He has a chance off ice, but Brent Seabrook with the bat check to knock him off the puck.
Great 80-foot pass, brings Sakic on the break, but Brent Seabrook showing he's still got some wheels and breaks up the play.
Under 30 seconds left in the period. Teravainen to Seabrook from a tough angle. His fifth, Hawks down by one.
Teravainen with great vision. Seabrook on his strong side finds a little daylight just inside the post. Hawks feeling good about themselves at the break.
Well, after being outshot 11-3 in the first, they outshoot Anaheim 13-5 in the second. Off to the third, Duck cycling. Silverberg in front. Matt Beleski's shot gets tipped over the net by Duncan Keith.
Straight bread and butter here by the Ducks. This is where they like to play, below the goal line, taking pucks to the net. But big, big stop here for the Blackhawks.
And then it's Kane and Teravainen who crisscross. Teravainen with the backhand. Andersen makes the pad save.
Freddie Andersen in position early, and he'll flare that pad. Excellent tracking of the puck through the screen as well.
5 minutes left in the game when it's Getzlaf to Vatanen to Patrick Maroon. Backdoor, his sixth with it. Getzlaf sets a franchise record with his 19th playoff point.
If you're out there on the ice with 15 black, just get open. He'll find you. Great play. Great heads-up play by Getzlaf.
So it's a 2-goal lead. Under 2 minutes left. Hossa to Toews. What a shot to cut the lead to one.
I didn't know that Toews could play the xylophone like that. He rings this one off the pipe. You kidding me? I've never seen him wire a puck that hard.
The Chicago Blackhawks still have life. Hossa sets up, and it's under 40 seconds left here. Andrew Shaw hard on the forecheck. Toews from a ridiculous angle ties in.
Who do you need now? Captain Clutch throws it in there. That's a tough angle to get that on net. Great shot. Second great shot of the period there for Toews.
For the third time in this series, we're going to overtime. 45 seconds into OT. Kessler puts it on net. Beleski follows up. He scores his seventh. That's the game winner.
Tough giveaway in the neutral zone, but the Anaheim Ducks with a neutral zone counter. Old play, shot pass, off the pad. Beleski, the former Belleville Bull, puts this game to bed out in California. The Ducks fans are going nuts.
What a scene in Orange County. Anaheim has now tied the 1979 New York Rangers as the only teams to start a postseason going 14 games without a regulation loss. Frederik Andersen also improves to 10-1 in his postseason career at the Honda Center. They win, though, because of Matt Beleski's goal in overtime, and afterwards he caught up with Brian Engblom on NBCSN.
Washington, D.C., America's capital, the political center of the country, full of landmarks and situated on the Anacostia River. Nationals Park, home to the NL East champion Washington Nationals, but this week home to the 2015 Bridgestone NHL Winter Classic. The ice looks good, the sun is out, we are ready for outdoor hockey in Washington as we welcome you in to NHL Live, powered by Constellation, joined by Barry Melrose, Kevin Weeks, EJ Raddick. I'm Mark Rowe, sitting in for Steve Mears, who's busy doing some hockey tournament in Montreal, but he's doing a great job. And guys, we're back. Barrett, you have the scarf, you have the NHL indoors gloves, you're ready to go. This is what we love.
Actually, I've been to all of them. I was in LA last year, which was the king as far as I'm concerned.
California's Bay Area, full of beauty and 40 miles south of San Francisco, the new jewel of the area, a $1.3 billion palace, Levi's Stadium, the usual home of the San Francisco 49ers, and it's brought the football player out of defenseman Brent Burns in anticipation of the 2015 Coors Light Stadium Series between the host San Jose Sharks and the defending Stanley Cup champion LA Kings. Located in the middle of Dignity Health Plaza on the south side of the stadium, you'll find our team of Marty Baron, Barry Melrose, Kevin Weeks,
Hi, everyone. I'm Mark Rowe. We are 90 minutes away from game time between the Sharks and the Kings. Expected crowd of close to 70,000 here in the Bay Area in Silicon Valley. We're looking forward to this one. And, guys, a huge game between two great teams fighting for their playoff lives. We love the weather. We love the crowd. We love the stadium. I think we're in love with this thing.
We certainly are. I know that I am.
It was a ceremonious night for the LA Kings, but one that ended a little sour with the San Jose Sharks defeating the Kings 4-0 back on opening night as we welcome you back to Levi's Stadium, getting set for the 2015 Coors Light Stadium Series between the Sharks and the defending Stanley Cup champion LA Kings. And we welcome in a special guest, Commissioner Gary Bettman. Mr. Bettman, thanks a lot for joining us.
It's great to be with you. What a wonderful night, and this setting is amazing.
Now, you're a very optimistic guy, but I don't even know if you could have predicted 15 or 20 years ago having a stadium in California, 70,000 fans out for what will be a great game.
Well, actually, if you think about this game and last year's at Dodger Stadium, that's 125,000 people watching two games in California. And when you think about the fact that grassroots participation, kids playing the game, since 1994 has increased approaching 100%. It's simply incredible, but it's a testament to the Sharks, the Kings, and the Ducks.
Welcome back. On Sunday, the Western Conference Final gets underway between the Blackhawks and the Ducks. Chicago took 2 out of 3 games during the regular season against Anaheim, but that just scratches the surface. With an in-depth look at the Conference Final, here are the insights by SAP.